Hi everyone, it's Andrew here, and I'm here to show you a new tutorial on how to build a LastFM widget on your website. Okay, here is the LastFM widget I built. It displays the last track I played that has been scrubbled. Currently, it's showing a track by Foles, and if I play another song from another album, like this one from the Beffs, next time I refresh the page on my website, it will show the latest one played or playing. We're now going to generate a LastFM API key. So head to the LastFM API website. It's lastfm/api account/create. I'm going to add that into the comments to generate a new API key. Once that's done, give your application a name, maybe like website widget demo. Fill in all the details. We won't be needing the callback URL. And after hitting submit, it'll create your account and display an API key. Create an ENV file. We're going to start by creating an ENV file. See, well, I've already created one already, .env. You can see that, and I have added a LastFM API key, and I'm going to copy that key into that position there. Create a serverless function. With Netlify, it's very easy to add serverless functions to your project. Serverless functions, also known as functions as a service, is a way of building and running computer programs without needing to worry about the underlying servers or infrastructure. Instead, a cloud provider takes care of managing the servers and resources, and developers can just write and deploy their code. Serverless functions are triggered by specific events or requests and can quickly execute and shut down when they're finished. This makes them efficient, cost-effective, and flexible. And they're often used for tasks that don't require continuous running or need to handle a lot of traffic. To be able to make a fetch request, I'm going to add the node fetch package to my project so we can make a get request from the LastFM API to get the last played track for my account. Once we have that set up, we can create a JavaScript function to make the GET request and return the result. I've made my function and imported node fetch, and then made a handler function for my GET request. I then pulled in my API key from the environment file that we created, and then you can see here we have a fetch request for the API key added as a string literal. I then created a last track object and retrieved the appropriate details from the JSON data requested and finally returned the result. You can see I have my LastFM username in the string for the URL that we're calling. You'll need to replace that with your own username. Fetch data. We now have a way to retrieve the data from LastFM in a secure way, protecting our API key. I've created a JavaScript file to run after the page has loaded. This is going to grab the data from our serverless function and append it to the page. You can see in my layout here, I have the basic structure of the widget with display none to hide it until the content has been loaded. Each of the IDs are targeted in the JavaScript with document get element by ID, with the style being set to display grid once loaded. The CSS for the widget is loaded here in the CSS file for the website. Install Netlify CLI. To make it easier to debug any issues before you release your function, I recommend you set up a Netlify CLI. check the instructions from the NETLIFY documentation. See the notes. Install the CLI tool globally by copying this command into your terminal. See the notes for the command. Once installed, add the NETLIFY dev command to your package.json file like so. Run local. Run NETLIFY dev from the command line, and this will start a local server that you can run your serverless function locally. It starts up the local serverless function dev server, and then it calls the npm start command to start the 11T dev server. Check out the link in the notes below, and you can see how to deploy your function.